In the last video, we have seen the frequency modulation, how it is generated. In frequency modulation, the frequency of carrier is changed in accordance with the message signal, amplitude of message signal. So the message signal is applied to the VCO. We'll see the slide, previous slide, what we have seen here, how the frequency modulation is generated. The message signal is given to VCO and carrier signal is applied to VCO. So the oscillations of this VCO is controlled by amplitude of this message signal. Therefore, the output of VCO will be a frequency modulated signal. So in this video, we'll be seeing the generation of phase modulation. First, we'll see what is phase modulation. The modulating signal, which we call it as message signal, changes the phase of the carrier signal. The phase change manifests itself as a frequency change, but the instantaneous frequency change is proportional to the derivative of amplitude. This is what the difference between APM and FM is. Here we'll see the generation of phase modulation. Again, here we'll be using the same blocks what we have used for the general FM modulation. These are the direct type of modulations, whether it may be a FM or PM. So here first what we'll do, we'll give the modulating signal, the audio, the original signal, to the derivative, a derivating device. Usually it is called as a differentiator. The output of differentiator is then given to the VCO. The output of differentiator changes the frequency of this VCO. Generally a VCO is nothing but a voltage controlled oscillator whose capacitance changes with the applied input voltage. So then what results is a general phase modulation. Here the bandwidth of this phase modulation where carrier frequency is centered. So here we need to understand that the amplitude changes the phase, whereas the frequency remains constant. In phase modulation, the frequency changes, but the amplitude and phase remains constant. This is the difference between FM and PM. Now this is what the generation we have seen. Then the bandwidth. Bandwidth is also calculated with the same formula, bandwidth PM, where PM denotes the phase modulation equals to 2 into 1 plus beta into B, where B is the bandwidth of the signal. Here the beta is almost equal to or greater than 2 when it compared to the FM. In FM it may be 1, which we call it as a narrow band FM. If it is more than 2, then we'll call it as a wide band FM, but in phase modulation it is always greater than 2. So the observation what we have to make between FM and PM waveforms is that both FM and PM waveforms are identical except the phase shift. So in PM what we have is phase shift, and frequency modulation we do not have that. For FM, the maximum frequency deviation takes place when modulating signal is at positive and negative peak. The meaning is that when the pitch raises very high and goes to very low peaks, then the frequency changes very rapidly. In PM, the maximum frequency deviation takes place near zero crossing of the modulating signal. The meaning is that the phase of the signal in the sense, the phase of the modulated signal changes when the peaks changes. It is difficult to know from the modulated waveform which is PM and FM. And comparison between them, maximum frequency deviation depends upon amplitude. Maximum phase depends upon the amplitude of the modulating signal, your frequencies. Then frequency of carrier is modulated by the modulating signal, phase is modulated. Modulation index is increased as modulation frequency is reduced. Modulation index remains same even if modulating frequency is changed. This is what the comparison between FM and PM. The advantages: has the amplitude of FM usually angle modulation, carrier is constant, the noise interference will be minimum. The amplitude of FM signal is constant and is independent of the depth of modulation, hence transmitter power remains constant in FM. In FM, depth of modulation can be increased any value without causing any distortion. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you understand this and you can make out the difference between FM and PM, thereby checking out how these are generated simply by direct means.